Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. And for this video today, I will be painting the first of my simple floral series. And I hope you will enjoy this series. I'm not going to try to paint realistic flowers, just very, very simplistic flowers. I am using this Clairefontaine Goldline sketchbook. And all the materials I'm using will be listed down in the description box, so you can go ahead and check it out. I'm starting off with just wetting the paper, picking up clean water with my brush and just splattering all over my paper just to get some watery parts. When I touch those parts with my brush, the water would spread and I think it will create a beautiful effect. Afterwards, with this round brush, I'm starting to paint a rose and I'm just painting a C shapes. As you can see, upper part doing some C and then a lower C on the side C, and that is basically how I paint my rose. I started with a very, very saturated paint, a lot of pigment in my brush, and then when I did do a couple of C's, I'm just rinsing my brush, drying it on my paper towel, but there is still some paint in my brush. I did not clean it completely. And then doing a little bit bigger C shapes to create the outer part of the rose. And that is basically it. That is how I'm painting the rose. Very, very simple. And you can see when I touch those parts that were wet from wetting the paper, from the splatters, that paint just spread beautifully. Just be careful when you paint your rose not to start in that part. Just try to avoid the center of the rose to be in that part where the splatters are. It should start in a dry place so that that part stays quite clear, and every other part of the rose, other larger petals, could be on that part, could bleed, could spread, whatever it happens, it will fine, even if they bleed more than in my painting, and that would be fine. You know, just leave the watercolors do their thing. You can also, when you do those larger petals with less paint in your brush, you can of course pick up a little bit more of the paint and add it here and there where you wanted it, where you want your rose to be a little bit darker. So those petals should not be equal. They should not be absolutely same color, but just add a little bit more pigment here and there. And now on the side, just painting the smallest rose. That's something like a rose bud. And that's basically it. I'm not going to complicate. And as I said, just do it as simple as possible. I also picked up a little bit of the color and added some splatters here and there. Just make it a little bit more interesting. Now I'm picking some dark brown from Etchr palette. And also I'm going to pick up a little bit of that forest, tropical forest from Altenew palette. I do love that color. The mix of those two colors just makes them tone down a little bit and creates a beautiful greenish brownish color that I really do love. With this quite very, very beautiful and thin brush from Lebenzon paintbrushes, I'm painting in the stems and I'm gonna paint them quite thin. And as you can see, I did pass over a part where the splatter was, where the water is. It spread slightly, but that's something that I don't mind. That is very, very nice and beautiful. Now just painting in those leaves, again very simple, and I do love this brush because you can do a little bit thicker strokes with it and also a thinner strokes with it. You can see how beautiful those rose leaves look, and just topping a little bit of the color here and there. I did not paint them, again very simple, just press my brush a little bit more at the bottom of the leaf and then pick it up and just did the curve for the top of the leaf. And I guess, as I said, very, very simple, picking up a little bit of dark brown just to make those stems just a little bit darker. And I guess that is it. And when I finished with that, I was just looking at my painting and I thought to myself, well, that rose on the right side just doesn't look right to me. So at the end, I decided to fix it slightly to add just a little bit more of the paint on the upper part of the rose, just to make it a little bit more nicer. As I said, it was just looking off, like some leaves, some petals were missing, so I decided to add a couple of those. Also picking up a little bit of the yellow, just to add it here and there to warm that color, to make that rose looking just a little bit warmer. And just to add, introduce a little bit one more color. And the paint was still wet, so that yellow was just spreading beautifully and all around. And that is it now. I did leave it to dry completely. And then when I finished it, when it was dry, I was looking again at that little rose, little bud, and it was just looking, well, it was just too blurred, but I did wanted to have a little bit more details. So now with this smaller round brush, I just added a couple of details, lower parts on some of the petals, and just to make that central part a little bit more detailed. And with that, I'll be finishing off, as I said, very, very simple. Just make the center focus, make the center stand out, and everything around it is just the way you want it to be. If you do like it, please hit the like button, share it, comment, and if you haven't, please do subscribe to my channel. A little bit more of those simple flowers coming up, and lots more other tutorials. So guys, thank you so much again for watching, and I hope I'll see you next time. Bye!